Good morning. Today let us see Wheatstone bridge. Last class we have seen Kirchhoff's first law and second law. Now we are going to apply both the laws in this Wheatstone bridge. This is the principle for upcoming classes. That is how to find the resistance using meter bridge, how to find unknown resistance using potentiometer, EMF, like this. For this is the basic principle. It is very simple. I will draw the circuit. You carefully watch how I am drawing the circuit and how I am proceeding the expression. It is very simple. Seems to be complicated circuit, but if you closely watch, then it is very simple circuit and simple derivation also. Now just point four points in a rhombus. Okay. Just point four points in a rhombus, just like you point here. Okay, four points I marked. Now connect these four points by a resistance. Connect these four points using a resistance. Okay, here also you connect. Okay, four points. Now you connected four resistance in this. Now you name it as A, B, C, D. Okay, now you connect this A and C through a cell you connect. Now these two points are there. Now you connect one galvanometer. Okay, this is called galvanometer G. In last class I told you this is positive terminal, therefore current is coming from this positive terminal only. Therefore, you mark this current as I. Now, I tell you one example. This is a pipeline. This is a pipeline or a water pipe. Now, here 10 liter water is flowing. For example, 10 liter water is flowing. Now, if there is another pipe in between this, another pipe is there. Now what will happen? This 10 liter will divide into two parts, not equal, depends upon the radius of the pipe. Now this is smaller radius compared to this one. Therefore, let us assume here 3 liter and here 7 liter. Okay. This 10 liter water is divided into 3 liter and 7 liter. Now 3 liter is flowing through this pipe and 7 liters flowing through this pipe. Now again one more division is there in this pipe. That means here it may be 2 liter and it may be 5 liter. Okay, it may be 5 liter. Now this 5 liter can be written as this 5 liter can be written as 7 minus 2 liter, both are same, because out of 7, 2 liter is flowing in this path and 5 liter is flowing in this path. That means this 5 can be written as 7 minus 2, this 5 liter. Okay. Now this pipe is flowing here. Now here these two pipes are open. That means here 7 liter is coming and here as usual 10 liter, provided there is no loss of water. Initially 10 liter water was there and there are 2 to 3 pipes Therefore, some water have been divided according to the radius of the pipes. Then finally, the same 10 liter is coming out of the pipe. Okay, provided there is no loss. Now just you compare this and this, analogous comparison. Okay. Now I current is flowing from this cell. You name it as E. I current is flowing from this cell. Just like water is dividing into two parts or three parts, depends upon the junction. Here current is dividing in the junction. Now this current is coming at this point. One junction is there, therefore current is dividing into two parts here. This I current is going here as I1 and this current as I2. It may be, for example, if it is 10 amperes, okay, for example I am saying, if it is 10 ampere, just take 10, it may be equal to 3, it may be equal to 7, okay, just two divisions. Now this I1 current is coming, and again one junction, in this junction B, two paths are there. Therefore, this I1 current, that is 7 ampere, is dividing into two paths. Okay. Now this is the galvanometer. One current is flowing in this direction. I name this as IG. Galvanometer current through the galvanometer. Therefore, it is IG. Now I take this as 2 ampere. Out of 7, I take this 2. Now here 5 ampere will be there. 7 minus 2, 5. Just like I have written 5 as 7 minus 2, I can write here I1 minus, I'll delete this, I1 minus IG, I1 minus IG. Okay. I1 current is flowing here and IG current is flowing here. Therefore, this current is I1 minus IG. Now, this current I2, okay, I'll delete this, okay, because it will confuse you, I'll delete this. Now, this I2 current and IG current are meeting at the point D, and it is flowing through this resistance, because current is flowing from positive to negative. Therefore, here it is negative. Therefore, these two currents are joining here. Therefore, this current is I2 plus IG, I2 plus IG. And at this point, these two, this current and this current are meeting. If you write here, I1 minus IG plus I2 plus IG, IG, IG get cancelled. That means this current and this current are meeting at the point C. Therefore, I am taking sum of this and this. Therefore, IG, IG cancel. Therefore, at the point you are having I1 plus I2. Here, I is divided into I1, I2, and both are joined here. Therefore, I current is coming in this path. Okay? Provided there is no loss. Just like I told you, provided there is no wastage of water, 10 liter is coming out. Here also, provided there is no loss, the same current I is coming here. Okay, that means 10 ampere means here also 10 ampere. Now no need to write this. I'll erase this. Okay. Now we have to mark the resistances. Okay. You mark this as P, this as Q, this as R, this as S. Okay. P, Q, R, S. And this G is the galvanometer. Galvanometer means it is a device to find the direction of the current. Usually this is 0, this is, for example, 5, this is 5. Okay? The current, if there is no current, the needle is showing 0. If the current is in left direction, then this needle will be left. If the current is right, the needle will be in this direction. Okay? Depends upon the direction, the needle will show this side or this side. That is the use of this galvanometer. Now, in some circuit they will include a key, but it is not necessary. Okay. Now current is flowing and the current is dividing into two, and current is flowing this galvanometer, current is flowing this resistance Q, and flowing this S, and meet at the point C, and it is coming towards the PM of negative terminal. Now we can apply Kirchhoff's second law and find the condition for this Wheatstone network. Now Kirchhoff's second law, I take the first closed path. I take from the point A, that means I take A, B, D, A. Okay. That means I am moving, I have taken this closed path, this triangle A, B, D, and then I mark D here. Okay. E, I mark here. Okay. A, B, D, A. This closed loop, this triangle I am taking. I told you in the Kirchhoff's second law, I have taken clockwise as positive. I have taken clockwise as positive and anti-clockwise as negative. Clockwise as positive, anti-clockwise negative. Here I am moving in this way, therefore it is clockwise. Here the current is I1, resistance is P, therefore I1P. According to the Kirchhoff's second law, current into resistance. Current into resistance from A to B. From B to C, or sorry, B to D, this triangle I have taken. Therefore, current is IG and the resistance of the galvanometer is G. Therefore, I take plus IG into G, where G is the resistance of the galvanometer. And I am moving from D to A. In last class, I told you, if the current is opposite to you, you have to take negative. Or in another way, the current is in the anti-clockwise direction. Therefore, it is minus I2R. In this closed path, there is no EMF. Therefore, EMF is equal to 0. EMF is equal to 0. Now, you name this equation as 1. You name this equation as 1. Now, you take another closed path. Now, you take another closed path. Since the derivation is lengthy one, I'll erase this. Okay. Now you take this closed path B, C, D, and then B. Okay. I start from B, C, D, and again B. Now again I am moving in a clockwise direction. Therefore, here the current is I1 minus IG, I1 minus IG into Q. I1 minus IG is the current. Current into resistance, resistance is Q. It is in the clockwise direction. From C to D, I am moving in this direction, but current is opposite to me. Therefore, minus I2 plus IG, minus I2 plus IG. And corresponding resistance is S. And I am moving from D to B. I am moving from D to B. Again, it is opposite to me. That means it is a anti-clockwise. Here we have taken clockwise because we moved along this line. Here I am moving in the opposite direction. Therefore, I take this as a minus IgG, which is equal to 0, because in this triangle also there is no cell. Therefore EMF is 0. That is no EMF. Therefore it is equal to 0. According to Kirchhoff's second law, product of current and resistance, algebraic sum of current and resistances, and it is equal to EMF. There is no EMF. Therefore 0. Now take this equation 2. Take this equation 2. Now what we are going to do is, just like water is flowing from high altitude to low altitude, current is flowing from high potential to low potential. If altitudes are same, that means there is no difference in height, water cannot flow. Water will be just like a pond. There will not be any flow. Just like the, if there is a equal potential of B and D, then there will not be any current through this. If there is a potential difference between B and D, then only current will flow in this direction or in this direction. But we made this is high potential, this is low potential. Therefore, current is flowing in this direction. Now you adjust this resistance. That means, this arrow means variable resistance. Now I am adjusting the resistance, just like a balance. In a balance, you put 2 kilograms here and you put some tomatoes here. Okay. Now your needle is in the left direction. That means 2 kg is more than this tomato. Okay. Now the needle is here. Now to balance this needle, you are adding tomato in this. Now your needle is here. That means you have added more tomatoes. That means now you have to remove this. If you remove one or two tomatoes, then the needle is coming at the center. That means two pans are balanced. When the needle is at the center, means two pans are balanced. That means here 2 kg, here 2 kg equivalent tomatoes. Okay, that means the balance is balanced. Just like you adjust the resistance so that the potential of B and potential of D are same. That means current will not flow in this wire or through this galvanometer. That means Ig equal to 0. You are adjusting by adding or removing the tomato. Just like you are adjusting the resistance and adjusting the potential of B and D and making us equal, therefore current through the galvanometer is 0. Understand? Now current through the galvanometer is 0. That means Ig equal to 0. It is called null deflection. Okay? Null deflection means Ig equal to 0. Now you substitute Ig equal to 0 in the equation as well as in this equation. Now if you substitute, what will happen? I1P, this is 0, minus I2R is equal to 0. Okay. Now because Ig equal to 0, only two terms are there. Now what will you have? You will be having I1P equal to I2R, which is equal, which is equation 3. Let us number it. Okay. Here what you have done? Ig equal to 0. If Ig equal to 0, I1P minus I2R equal to 0. Now you take this I2 to the another side. Therefore, you are having I1P equal to I2R. Now the same condition here, Ig 0. Therefore, you are having I1 into Q minus I2S. Again, this is 0 equal to 0. If you take this I2 to another side, then it equal to I1Q equal to I2S. Now equation 4. Okay. Now divide equation 3 by 4. Okay. 3 by 4. Now you will get I1P by I1Q equal to I2R divided by I2S. Now I1 cancel, I2 cancel. Therefore you are having P by Q is equal to R by S. P by Q equal to R by S. This is the condition for balancing the bridge. Okay, this is the condition for balancing the bridge. Balancing means what? Balancing means current through the galvanometer is 0. That means the needle shows 0 deflection, null deflection. We adjust the resistance and we made the current 0 and we derived this condition. Therefore, this is the condition for null deflection in the galvanometer. Therefore, it is called balancing condition for Wheatstone network. It means not P equal to R or Q equal to S. The ratio of P by Q is equal to the ratio of R by S. Just for example, P by Q equal to 2 by 3. It is equal to 4 by 6. Okay. For example, P by Q equal to 2 by 3 means R by S equal to 4 by 6. That means it is also equal to 2 by 3 if you cancel. That means this ratio of and this ratio of are equal. This is the condition for Wheatstone network. We apply this principle in next class in the meter bridge or slide wire bridge. That is, that instrument is used to find the unknown resistance. Let us see in the next class. Thank you.